Ars Poetica. I see a therapist every Thursday. The therapist has one eye for eye movement desensitization reprocessing. I hand the therapist the letter the mother had typed and mailed to the new roommate. The mother will never meet. The letter has no room for stanzas or a return address or an apology. To the therapist, the mother writes with ink of guilt, a graph of the mother's paranoia that the roommate knows the truth. I don't tell the mother. I don't spare time to talk about the heavy-handed. Or when she pushed me on the front porch and not locked the door, because I was no good. I am no good. That's why my sculptures were returned to the graveyard. Poetry should be wordless, but I hear the mother, the father do not want you. The grandmother does not care to let you in. Do not get too close to me. I am very lonely. The therapist asks me how that makes me feel. I tell her I am fine. I do not spin my tragedies into poetry. The therapist asks how I really feel. I am fun. I am doing fine. If I wrote a poem, that's what I would title it. I fall out of improvisational movement class to crouch next to the trash can in the bathroom. My body is an alarm clock that wakes you so abrupt it slides off your nightstand. My eyelids are wings of a hummingbird. My mind serves channels of nightmares. The history of grief, an open doorway in a maple leaf. A bathroom of Catherines who sweep my tears off the tile floor. I do not tell the Catherines that I am not a dancer. Bessel van der Kolk says trauma lives in the body. I say trauma is a rabid dog that is biting me again and again. Do not get too close to me. I am very lonely. Memory by memory, the mind's eye writes poems in my sleep. My roommate from the hospital wakes to tell me that in my sleep I cry out. I tell her that in my dreams, I am a deer I am a fawn caught in a chain link fence, and that is why I am screeching. She tells me her earplugs do not work. I could point to the places on this campus where I've been assaulted, but that wouldn't be poetry, that would be directions. And I tried to tell the therapist how maybe the best poem is always one you shouldn't have written. A dying garden's as good as any. This summer is no wander, no wander. Flashbacks on dead grass under the shadows of deflated fences. Not everything blooms here. Cat parades her fuzzy parachute everywhere. Under the carpet of humidity, she says, sad cat, don't know her. Neither of us are good at soccer. Vocabulary removal from lips to chalkboard. Lessons from a traffic light. Try to find a corner that smells like safety, pacing with your legs up the wall. Don't call me by my name. I have no home, no phone. Sadness, supply, and surplus overflow. Do not ask who is crying. I cannot see their face. The mind's torn letters are never sent. Some nights she calls across the death ocean to no one in particular. No answer. Final fluid leak will get you shipped to Sacramento or San Francisco. Spring may never come, so don't throw out your sweaters. A blind friend teaches me how to see and how to grow a new body. Press against the window for a spirit with footsteps and basketball shoes. Where are you? I just wanted to hear your voice, but you've lost it. Clean your room, maybe you'll find it, I say. You say you ate your apartment key for breakfast. Baptized in hand-squeezed orange juice, let the feathers free. Don't crouch and cry unless it's raining. With each gaunt memory, your youth rises with the sun. Who is this child and where did she come from? Crybaby ain't got no rhymes, for when I cry, I soak the feet of sinners in salt. A dying garden's as good as any. Waits in line to use the landline. Her mother's mouth full of metal and well, you know what, you never. Her mother at the airport saying don't come back. Your mother on the front porch, we don't want you back. When neither of us wanted me anywhere. Little sister on the front porch locked out with you. Mother's fingers can't pull her away, little sister will cry for you and let you borrow her suitcase. Please find my paintbrushes in case I never come back, I can paint the truth. Your sister will lend you her golden hair. A dying garden's as good as any.